Welcome back. My stomach is full. They are incredible, let me tell you. All right, we're going to get now in the Christmas spirit a little bit with a trip to Canton. We are live at the Ohio Christmas Factory. And owner John, you look at you all decked out, John, in your awesome Christmas attire. This place looks a lot less scary than the last time I was there.
Oh, it's not scary today, though. We're all dressed up and happy, family friendly. It's a whole different show.
So for those who don't know what I'm saying, I went down to the factory there. We did a whole haunted tour because they do it up for Halloween. But so you figured switching over into the holiday season here of Christmas and getting everybody in the Christmas spirit, this really becomes a family affair.
Yes, so we switched out our show. All the scary is behind closed doors someplace else. We have a new space down here, and it's all family friendly. And you're going to take a look, a little preview of what we have here. We have some fun characters that will greet guests.
They're very friendly.
We probably have like a, oh yeah, there's like a dozen of them. And the kids take pictures with them. They love them. They hug them. And it's really special. But families are having an incredible time here just visiting the characters and the sceneries.
You have decked
so
this place
we're excited.
Out. Look at that, those big, the big bulbs, the bulbs, the millions. How many trees do you have set up there?
We have about 150 trees, and there's probably 50 that are themed, decorated, and there's a lot of like general, just simpler trees, but about 150. And now we're headed to the candy cane lane.
It has the wow factor, John. This is incredible. You've put so much effort into this.
Oh, yeah, we've been working on this for about a year now, and we're extremely excited about this. There's photo ops everywhere, and the more you look, the more you find. That's kind of how it is. We're kind of sneaking back here to a Grinch area, so we have an area like an old grungy cave, and you can get a photo here. I think you're looking at it probably now.
We see it with a little sleigh.
So that's been a fan favorite with the Grinch. Because we do have Santa on site for photos.
Oh, wonderful.
The neat thing is we also have the Grinch.
That's good. You got to have both, right? It's in the true spirit
Absolutely.
Of everything. We got to have the Grinch there, too, because, you know, we can change that heart of his. So am I mistaken? Is this your first year of doing this, or have you done this in years past and I was just missing out this whole time?
Yes. No, this is year one for this attraction, and we set it in a part of the building that we're going to leave it set up year-round. Now, we're not going to be open year-round. We're just, you know, we're not going to take the displays down. We're just going to continue to improve them. We have new features coming in each year for the next 3-4 years. That's going to be an ongoing tradition. Families are already talking about coming here every year because our feedback has been amazing.
It's
going to be a destination. Yeah, it's going to be a destination and a place that you want to come every year. So
let me know that, make sure that I'm getting all this correct then. So when people come in, they're going through, they can see all these beautiful displays set up. They'll see Santa when they're there. There's beautiful ops for pictures. What else am I missing?
Well, you know, Christmas is about spending a lot of time with friends and family. So there's tons and tons of photo ops. So there's photo ops everywhere, and guests can kind of free flow at their own pace and just create some fun within our space.
Mm-hmm.
And it's proven there's funhouse mirrors. There's a great mirror maze we've repurposed from Halloween to Christmas.
Oh,
we have spinning tunnels, and we also have our dance floor. So in Halloween time, we have an LED light-up dance floor. So now we see kids, you know, ages 4 and 5 out there on the light-up dance floor with grandparents and parents, and they're just having a riot. I mean, it's so much fun to watch. It's just a riot.
I mean, and what's really awesome about this is no matter what the weather is like on any given day in the wintertime, they can come indoors, be warm, and really experience Christmas in the way they want to. And now I know you're having an ugly sweater party, and we're seeing the information here on the screen right now. That's December 14th at your facility there in Canton.
Yes, next Thursday, and that's an adult only. So that's our only date that is adults only. And it's for the ugly sweater. That's why I had my sweater on today.
And
behind me, you see my giant gingerbread house?
I love it. And I don't know if it's just me, but I love ugly Christmas sweaters. I think they're actually very cute. That is an awesome sweater. And I think it'd be fun if the adults want to get out and enjoy an evening to themselves.
Get a beer holder.
Oh, look, you can put something in there. That's awesome. Thank you so much, John, taking us through. Go ahead.
Oh, I'm sorry. We also have prizes for the ugly sweater, but we also, every child, they want to participate in the Naughty Nice.
Very cool.
They can qualify, and the parents can put them on either not air nice list, and they go home with this certificate. And I tell you what, the parents and the kids are so excited to get this. People are clapping, and the smiles are just enormous when they get this certificate.
I love it.
There are
John,
a few naughties, but most of them are nice.
I bet. So. I gotcha. All right, John, joining us again from the Ohio Christmas Factory today there in Canton. Thank you so much. It looks fabulous. You've done a wonderful job. David, over to you.
All right, take care.
That sweater wasn't too ugly, was it?
I loved it.
It was nice.